So I probably should be sleeping right now. It's midnight, but then again, I was like, please, no sleep. So I was like, yay, let's shoot a video. And yay, just 10 days for Diwali. And yeah, it's like 13th and 10 days for Diwali. It's like, whoa, Diwali is right here. And Diwali is like one of the majorest, like, I know majorest is not a word, but majorest celebration in India. So I thought, why not do a DIY room decor for Diwali? Because I had been searching online so much and I couldn't find like a good video for it. So I was like, you know what, I'll do it myself. So all the decorations are up here in my room as usual. Like my last video, I still have some of those from my last video, which if you want to see, I will link here or in the bottom bar. And if you can see, I have my diyas right there, my lotus right there, my Ganeshji right there, if you can see that, I don't know. But yes, you will see, and all the other things are like in this room. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, so yes, if you guys want to know how to do like some cute Diwali decorations to get your Diwali on. Wow, to get your Diwali on. Yeah, I should really sleep because midnight time makes me crazy. Do you see it in my eyes? I'm crazy, like crazy eyes. Okay, yeah, what else? So yes, if you want to know some cute Diwali DIYs, and you can also give some of those, I will tell you in the video itself. And if you do try these out, then don't forget to tweet or Instagram it to me. I love to see you guys' recreations. Wow, top flanking. Whew. Yes, so I'll go back to sleep now and you should see the DIYs now. So our first DIY is going to be this lotus. Lotus is a symbol of goddess Lakshmi, so you want to make those. For this is going to be a really simple one. You're going to be needing two coolers or vases like this, which are like really pretty and decorative. I got mine from a flea market. And you're going to need lotus, which I got from Kolkata. They're like really pretty as well. They're like foam lotuses. I'm going to use the pink ones and I'm just going to simply place them over these coolers and they look really pretty like this, and just done, right? And you can place them anywhere in your room to make it brighten up. Next, I'm going to make this hanging diya, which is made out of a strainer or a channi as we name it in India. For this, you're going to be needing channis. I have mine right here. They were like 10 bucks each. And then I'm going to just use a cutter to cut excess of the channi so that it doesn't have that rounded edges, so that it looks like this. And you can use, and then I'm going to take a compass and I'm going to pierce this middle parts of the sides from where my handle will go. Now this is what my channi looks like. I'm going to use the red one first, and that's the only one that I use. So I'm going to use the red one. I'm going to take some fishnet thread and some pearls, and I'm going to put through the pearl through the fishnet, and I'm going to put it through the strainer. Okay, so that was a lot of detail. So that's just like I'm threading a pearl onto the strainer, and I'm going to tie a knot above so that it stays there and doesn't fall off. And then you're going to do that multiple times. You're going to be taking fishnet thread again. And now you're going to be making the handle so that the areas that we've pierced using a compass, I'm going to put it through while just knotting it down so that it stays in place, so that it's like a handle. And this is what the end product looks like. You want to take a gel candle and you want to put it on the strainer, and then you can hang it anywhere that you like. It would look really pretty like that. Next, I'm going to be making Ganpati ji on a money plant leaf, and this, you can gift this to anyone that you like. It's going to be really pretty. You want to take a money plant leaf like so, and then you want to take a glitter pen and you want to trace out an abstract Ganesh ji. You can trace out any shape that you like. So like any shape of Ganesh ji. There are like multiple abstract forms of Ganesh ji. Mine looks like this. I'm just going to show it to you in a while, and this is just a trace out, so don't worry. Mine looks like this, and then I'm going to use glitter glue to just make it a lot more vibrant and a lot more prettier. So after that, you want to let it dry overnight so that it's completely dry. And I'm just going to show it to you in a while. It looks like this. I'm going to let it dry overnight, and in the morning I'm going to remove the backing paper of my photo frame, and I'm going to cut out an A4 sheet of the same size so that to fit into the photo frame. And then very carefully with my Fevicol, I'm going to just stick my leaf down onto that white paper that I've cut according to the backing paper. And then I'm going to put it back again in the photo frame so that it looks really, really pretty. And this is the complete one. And this is like really pretty. I really like this DIY. So this is how it looks on my side table. Next is a Vandanwar. It's a must. You can put it up on your door or on your entrance of the house, wherever you like. So I'm going to take a yellow sheet. You want to use bright colors, you guys, because it's Diwali, happy time. And I'm going to make a shape like a square on a triangle or a triangle on a square, which looks like this. And I'm going to cut it out, because this is the traditional Vandanwar shape. I'm going to cut it out, and once I have cut it out, I'm going to use it as a stencil to trace out 8 more such
shapes and I'm gonna use one more shape which is slightly larger than this, like the same shapes but slightly larger, like 1 centimeter. And these are my 8 cutout shapes. Then you want to take a pink paper and I'm going to just cut out circles, multiple circles at one time using the fan method, which is like you fold a paper into fan, and these are my 8 circles. Now next, using Fevicol, I'm going to stick down these to the centers of the earlier cutout shapes. Next, I'm using golden glitter pen to make borders on each of the Vandanvar shape. And this is how it looks, all my Vandanvar shapes. Next, I'm going to use red pen from Stedler Color Collections. And I'm going to make some traditional graffiti only on 4 of these shapes. Not on all, only on 4 of these shapes. So I'm just going to make some traditional graffiti. And then I'm going to use some mirror sequence, which looks like this. It's a sequence which looks like mirror. And I'm going to stick it down to the center of the pink circle. And I'm going to do it to all of like 4 of my graffitied Vandanvar shapes. And I'm also going to do this to the plain 4 ones. I have plain 4 ones, remember, and I'm going to just stick them down as well. Then on the plain ones, I'm going to use a compass to pierce a bottom part of my Vandanvar, and I'm going to put through a bell onto them. And on the larger one, what you want to do is, like, this is how it looks, and I have like my 3 more here. And on the larger one, what you want to do is that you want to put up a larger bell. This is my larger one, and you want to trace out a satya or a swastik. And then using the red pen again, I'm just going to brighten it up, like not brighten it up, I'm going to fill it in, and I'm going to just thicken it up a bit and then fill it in as well, like so. And the final product of my satya is this. It looks really pretty. Then I'm going to take some thread and I'm going to measure the width of my door, and I'm going to cut some extra so you can hang it. And then you want to put across how you want your Vandanvar to be. And then you want to take thread and put it above it, and then you want to flip your Vandanvar like so, and like all the shapes of the Vandanvar. And then I'm going to apply thin lines of Fevicol onto my Vandanvar, and I'm going to put the thread on it, and I'm going to let it dry overnight before I hang it on my door the other day, like so. Next, we're going to make these diyas on our bed hanging, which are going to look really, really pretty, and it's going to bring your Diwali mode on. For this, you're going to be needing an A4 sheet, and I'm going to trace out a diya. You can trace out any shape of diya that you like, but mine particularly would look like this. And then I'm going to cut it out again, like again, right? And then using the fan method, as you can see, I folded my paper into a fan. I'm going to make multiple diyas and cut out multiple diyas at one time. Bam! Then I'm going to take my high school musical kit of colors. Yes, I do have one. And I'm going to color my diyas. I know this looks a little kiddish, but hang on with me, guys. It looks really pretty once it's done. So this is my diya, and I'm going to color like multiple diyas, like so. And then I'm going to take my fishnet thread again, which is like a transparent wire, and I'm going to tape down my diyas. And once I have taped down my diyas at a space, a particular space like so. Oh, hi, I'm here. I'm going to tape one side on one side of my bed, like I'm going to leave some extra part of it, and the other on the other side. And I'm going to just adjust it a little so that all the diyas are facing like right way. And this is how it looks. Pretty, right? Next, we're going to make this candle. You can also not burn it if it's like a zardia, so you want to be careful with it. So yeah, please be careful with it. For this, we're going to be needing some candles. These are like dirt cheap, and you get like a bunch of them. So you want to take out a handful of them so that they kind of make a circle, like so. And then you want to just tape the bottom section of it so that it stays in place. Also, you want to tape center section of it, which is going to be like a marker for us, as well as it's going to help the candle stay in place. You get it, right? So this is what my candle would look like now. And you want to take tree branches next, and you want to cut a little bit above the tape, like you, and you want to take a bunch full of them. And then you want to take your candle, which looks like this, and taking my hot glue gun, I'm going to stick down the branches onto them so that the branches will hide the tape as well as look really pretty, like really pretty. I really like this DIY. So I'm just sticking down the branches, and you want to be careful. You don't want to burn your hand, and this is what it looks like. And then again, I'm going to take this thread, and I'm going to just put it across a few times. I'm going to wrap my candle around a few times, and I'm going to tie a knot, and then I'm going to snip the excess part off, like so. And this is the DIY done. It looks really, really pretty and really rustic. It would look really rustic sitting just like that, or you can even burn it, but again, be careful with it. Next, what is a Diwali without a rangoli? So we're going to be making this transportable rangoli, which you can put up anywhere that you like. For that, we're going to be needing ivory board, which is like a thick A4 sheet, like so. and then I'm gonna make out a circle. Like, I'm not gonna make out, but I'm just going to make a circle, and I'm gonna cut it out like so. It's really easy, guys. Every DIY is really, really easy. And then I'm gonna make some concentric circles inside my circle. So it's like concentric circles. You get it, right? You get it? It's easy. So this is what the concentric circles would look like. And in the smallest of the circle, I'm gonna make Goddess Lakshmi's feet, which is like them entering, sort of. And then I'm gonna make a simple design, like so. This is what my design looks like. And then I'm going to take my high school musical kit again, and I'm going to use the water paints right here, and I'm going to use all bright colors like red for the feet. Especially for the feet, you want to use just red. And then tons of different colors, bright colors, yellow, blue. It's Diwali, guys. Use bright colors to paint my rangoli, and this is the final product. You can put it up anywhere and it would like look really pretty.
Like this, if you did, then please rate, comment and subscribe. It would mean a lot to me. And again, if you do try these out, then don't forget to tweet or Instagram it to me. I would love what you guys made. And yes, 10 days left, but still happy Diwali in advance and yes, I have a Twitter and Instagram, a Facebook and a blog. Links to all would be in the bottom bar. Also, again, if you share this with me, you can also hashtag it with Diwali with SJ. It's being a little ambitious, but still, why not? So hashtag Diwali with SJ, and I would love to see what you guys make. And yes, just good night. Go away, guys. Bye.